What's happening, YouTube boxing universe, man? Welcome to Boxing After Dark with your host, Nocturnal Thoughts. Hey, man, before I get started on this real quick video, it's two things I got to mention. You know what I'm saying? First of all, salute goes out to H Money. It's a boxing channel, H Money Boxing. He did a live last night. Conveniently for Nocturnal, man, it was like 4 a.m. and I clicked over. I'm pretty sure I subscribed to his channel, but that was my first time being on a live, and I caught the tail end of it. But you know what? I want to start getting on more lives. First of all, I definitely want to get on Red Glove Militant. He does lives all the time. I always miss him. For some reason, it'd be like stream 30 minutes ago, stream the hour ago. And I owe that brother some of my time, you know what I'm saying? Because he's done so much for this platform. And I just really have been looking forward to, you know, conversating with this guy really getting to a, I'm getting to a point where it's time for me to jump on some of these lives. Put it like that. He knows the sports. I owe you a live. Salute. I can't wait. I can't wait personally to get on Punch Drunk Boxing Live. You know what I'm saying? That's a goal. And hopefully I get to do that ASAP. And also, see, Red Glove Militant, Punch Drunk. Who else? This is another live that I've been wanting to get on. It'll come. Famous AAA. I want to do a live with him. So it's time for me to get out there and branch out and start, you know, getting on some of these platforms that I respect and, you know, just chopping it up with all these other guys that's talking about boxing on YouTube. All right. So shots out to H Money. I enjoyed your live. I got to go back and watch the playback. I think that thing is like 9 hours long. So I can't do that, but I'm gonna try to consume as much as possible. You dig what I'm saying? But thanks and salute for having me on the platform, man. I really appreciate you. And anybody that knows about my channel should know about his channel. But just in case you don't know about his channel, click over H Money Boxing and subscribe to the channel. He's doing some good work. Another thing I got to mention before I talk about David Benavides and Charlo. I don't know if anybody caught the news last night. I can't remember where this happened at, but it was an accident where a single engine plane had a crash landing and it just came and it wiped out a SUV that was driving down the road. And there was a fatality involved of a little kid. And I believe the pilot probably passed away. The mother who was driving the SUV, I think she survived, and I think her son, who was a kid, passed away. So if you didn't see that on the news, you can go over on YouTube and put in, you know, single engine plane crashes into car or vehicle. You can look it up, but I ask you, you know, if you were listening to me and you go click over to watch this video, please do it with all due respect and, you know, show respect to the fact that there was a infant that had a fatality. And you know, it's not just for entertainment, and I'm not trying to use this as entertainment, but I'm just, it just, if you watch the video, it's just, if you see it at the timing, when you see a car accident happening, you understand that things just lined up for that to happen when it happened the way it happened. But to see a plane come out of the sky and all the possibilities where it could have landed in this big field of grass, acres of grass, could have landed on this big, it just landed and hit this car and wiped out this car and blew up, and the fire spread across the screen because it all got recorded on like a, on a, you know, camera on somebody's house or something. To see the timing, I mean, you talking about, it was just a butterfly effect of, you know, seconds. Like, if she would have been driving and something would have delayed her 10 seconds, or something would have sped her up 10 seconds would have been a totally different situation, where she would have been 10 seconds of just seeing the airplane crash and go past, or 10 seconds of seeing it in her rearview mirror. But it just was that time where it all happened tragically, freak accident, but it's not a freak accident in my opinion. It's no coincidences in life. It's just the way that God works, the way the universe works. It was just the time for that to happen. And ain't no other way. If you watch that video, it just brings it to the reality of the way time is. You ever leave your house on a pursuit to go somewhere and you forget your keys and you're like, I gotta find my keys, and it take you 5 minutes to find your keys and you cussing the whole time, God damn it, where's my keys at? And that could be God saving your life by just making you adjust your plans by 2 minutes. You never know what you could have went out into the world and happened in just a 2 minute. I mean, this was literally, if it would have been anything that delayed her, if she would have tripped and fell and stubbed her toe, or if she would have forgot her keys, or if she would have, if anything would have happened that would have delayed her 10 seconds in her travels, that wouldn't have happened. So it's just mysterious to me, but it's also just makes me want to tell everybody to appreciate everything that happens to you. You know, if you lose your keys and you leave your house, don't curse God and don't get pissed off. Just take it in stride and say, everything happens for a reason and I'm blessed. You dig what I'm saying? Anyways, man, not to no thoughts. We're talking about some boxing, but I want to make this video under 12 minutes. So here we go. Jamar Charlo, David Benavides, the conversation is starting to pick up. And that's what I was calling in to talk about on the live with H Money. I watched David Benavides versus Anthony Durrell, the dog. I watched David Benavides against Ronald Ellis. And then I went and watched Jamar Charlo against Devorinchenko. And then I watched Jamar Charlo against Julian J. Rock Williams. And I'm telling you, 50-50 fight, most definitely. I like the Charlo brothers. You can go through my catalog and see. I've always given nothing but respect and props to them Houston boys and Errol Spence. But the Charlo brothers, I rock with them. I think they solid. I love their energy. I love their ferociousness. I love the Lions, you know what I'm saying, Lions only club. I even like the way, you know, you've watched me on live. I even like the way sometimes they do get over emotional. They are passionate. They do, you know what I'm saying, put their heart on their sleeve and you know what you see. I dig all that. But me personally, I like the way that David Benavidez is just real stoic about, man, I just want to fight. I'll whoop these dudes' ass. He don't have to put a lot of extra spin on it. He just real straightforward, blunt, and, you know what I'm saying, monotone about giving somebody an ass whooping, and that's just how I am. Like, I can whoop your ass and not even lose my damn, I can nonchalantly whoop your ass. That's just how I always been. I don't have to get worked up about stuff. My energy, what you see is not what you get. I could fuck you up and not be pissed off about it. You know what I'm saying? So anyways, I like that smile. You know what I'm saying? Some people, man, when they get hit or they get hurt, they shake their head. No, you didn't hurt me. But I like when a dude get hit and they just smile and they just wave you in. But anyways, I see it's a 50-50 fight, and I hope that we get to see this fight. But I don't feel like people respecting David Benavidez, man. I think a lot of people thinking that Charlo got the power to where David Benavidez is not going to be able to just walk him down in the guard. And look, man, Contender Regime, he also inspired this video, because he did a video talking about, you know, Jamar Charlo being on the Last Man Standing podcast with Brian Custer, just that little bitty clip he released. Charlo was talking that big talk, and it's cool. But check it out, man. The way Anthony Durrell is a natural 168-pounder, and the way he moves, he can box and use the square circle, but he couldn't stay away from David Benavidez. Contender regime said all Benavidez does is kind of walk you down, straight down the line and walk you down, and he's like Frankensteinish. And to me, David Benavidez is not like Frankensteinish. To me, David Benavidez is more like Michael Myers or Jason. You remember in the scary movies where the person would just take off running, and you would see Michael Myers just walking regular pace, or Jason would be walking in regular pace, and the person running, cutting through the woods and dipped and doing all this, and as soon as they trip and fall, dude just right behind them. He's just walking. They run in full steam, and as soon as they turn around, he's just right behind them. That's, to me, David Benavidez. He doesn't look like he's moving fast to cut off that ring, but dude is just, you know, his reach, how tall he is, the way he can cover the, he takes little steps and cut you off and trap you, where you can be doing all this running, but you can't get away from him. You don't, and it's not like he's just walking you straight down. He's taking little steps and working at little angles that's, you know what I'm saying, squaring off the circle. Is that how you say that? I think that's how you say that. But he's doing things that's cutting you off, because Anthony Durrell can box. He can move around the ring. Ronald Ellis can move. He's fast. He can move around the ring, but he couldn't escape. He's getting beat from pillar to post. You know, I don't think his footwork would even be an issue with Jermall Charlo, because Jermall Charlo is not the one who's going to be on a bicycle. Jermall Charlo is going to come forward too. Jermall Charlo is more like a, you know, he will sit and wait for the fight to unfold. He's a counterpuncher, but he can bring it to you. But he's more dominant on the front foot. He's not just a back foot fighter. He comes forward, and his power versus power. This fight is, to me, both of these guys is going to come like this, right in the middle of the square circle, you know. And it's going to be a battle of attrition, a battle of nutrition, and a battle of who's the strongest and who's the most dominant physically. Now, I know it's Lions Only. I dig Lions Only. But lions ain't just the baddest animals walking the planet. You know, you ever watch the National Geographic and watch the Planet Channel like I do? You know what I'm saying? I've seen a lion try to take a chunk out of a giraffe's ass. And the giraffe reached back and kicked with his back leg, and it didn't even look like much. It just was like a get off me, defensively. And that lion took one to the chin, walked off, laid down and died from starvation because he broke his jaw. I mean, lions are a beast, but it's other beasts out there in the jungle. And I mean, I'm just saying, David Benavidez has some weapons. They both have some firepower, but I'm looking at Derevchenko getting off on Jermall Charlo, but Jermall Charlo got that granite vibranium chin. But he was taking some shots. He was taking some shots against little Dennis Hogan. Derevchenko is smaller. I mean, he's fast and everything, but Jermall Charlo is one of his biggest weapons is that uppercut. And Derevchenko was perfect to get caught and knocked out by an uppercut, and he landed the uppercut a couple of times, and Derevchenko never went down. He never sat him down. Daniel Jacobs sat down Derevchenko, and Triple G knocked down Derevchenko, I think, in the first round. Jermall Charlo is nothing but power and explosiveness, but I would like to see him do a little bit more feigning and setting a little bit more traps. I just see that if he's not fighting the proper fight, you know what I'm saying? If Rodney Shields doesn't come up with the perfect game plan, and he takes David Benavidez for granted in any kind of form or fashion, and think he's just like a Frankenstein walking forward and going to be walking into all his bombs, I think he's thinking wrong. David Benavidez is a lot more elusive. He's a lot more, what you see is not what you get. He's doing things that I think is not, because it looks awkward. He throws punches in bunches, but he's not digging up underneath. He's not putting all of his legs underneath him, and he's not dick. But he doesn't have to. He has freaky power. That's his punches are powerful punches. It may be fast sometimes, and they are arms. But when he hits you with that jab, man, his jab is long and snappy, and you gotta respect it. And I just see him having the weight advantage, having the youth advantage. it's 50-50 in my mind. I'll be pulling for Charlo in this fight if it happens, because I definitely support the Charlo brothers. But I'm just saying, I would not be surprised. I don't see a knockout, honestly. I don't see a knockout. But I do see that Jamal might... He has to have both of these guys got to have the perfect fight. You know, y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments below. I don't want this video to stretch out way too long. It's already 15 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and salute and sign off. But to everybody out there, man, I appreciate y'all time. Y'all need to appreciate y'all time too. You know what I'm saying? Even if this 15 minutes video might save your life today. Nocturnal Thoughts. Salute. Bow. Peace.